Hello, this is Marshall Mutt here, and I'm going to talk to you today in this video about demand. So let's start with the law of demand. Basically, the law of demand states that there is an inverse relationship between price and quantity of a good that's being sold, with this caveat of ceteris paribus. Ceteris paribus, as you remember from chapters 1 and 2, simply means that all other things being held constant. That's a rule we need to apply to make sure that we can just compare price and quantity without having to worry about all the other side effects that might be affecting what's going on in the market. Okay? So what does inverse relationship mean? Inverse relationship basically states that when the price goes up, quantity goes down. So if we were to look at a graph of price and quantity, and do realize that these are the standard axes, labels, when you're dealing with economic markets, here is what a demand curve looks like, right? So it's an inverse relationship, it's decreasing. As price goes up, quantity will go down. If the price is currently set right here, what's going to happen is that the amount that we are going to buy, or the amount that we are going to demand, shoot the price over till it intercepts the demand curve, go down to find out where it hits the quantity. This will be the price and quantity that will be purchased in this market, assuming the price was set here. If the price goes up, naturally, the quantity should go down, and you can see that by shooting the price over to where it hits the curve and coming down to see where the quantity is going to be changed to. All right, this is our basic model for what demand looks like. Now, what we have to worry about is how do things move along this curve? Well, this, when price goes up, when price rises, this is what's known as creating a change in the quantity demanded. So when the price of, in this case, let's suppose we were working in the corn market, classic economic market to work with, if the price of corn rises, the quantity that we demand will fall from this value to this value. That's a change in quantity demanded. Now, when we're dealing with these graphs, one of the other things that we have to worry about is not just a change in the quantity demanded, but an actual change in demand. So what's going to change the actual demand curve or make this demand curve move? That is a change in demand. So let's take a look at that really fast. So here we have our standard price and quantity demand curve. And I will always abbreviate P and Q for price and quantity, just so that you know. Similarly with my demand curve. Now, what makes a change in demand? A change in demand. And this is different than a change in quantity demanded, right? This is where ceteris paribus is released, right? We allow some other factor to change. And there are a certain set of factors that are going to change what our demand is. One of the classic ones is the number of people who are buying a particular good. If you think about it, this might be my demand curve for what I demand corn, how much corn I demand given a certain price. If we add additional people to the corn market who are going to buy corn, so imagine that all of you are going to start going out and buying corn, which I'm sure you do, what happens to the curve is that it actually shifts entirely. So the market represents this additional buyers as a shift in the demand curve, and it actually moves the demand curve to the right. Okay, that's a key point that we have to deal with when we're working with economics, right? Is the difference between a change in a demand and a change in quantity demanded. This tends to confuse students because it looks like those are the same thing, right? Changes in demand are where we change ceteris paribus. Changes in quantity demand is simply a change in the actual price.